last week, 40,000 accounts payable for expenses, not fees legally, 100,000 for the bond and 50,000 for security. Is that the accounting we're talking about? Is there anything we're missing? Is that where the money's gone?
I think that's close, yeah. I mean, we spent about 40,000, about $50,000 on security. I'm not sure all of that's been paid yet, but I know it's outstanding. Like you said, about $100,000 in bond monies. Doesn't leave very much, I can tell you that.
The parents of Trayvon Martin spoke out this morning when it came to the comments George made about being God's will, and they said his mother, Sabrina Fulton, that it's ridiculous. So what do you have to say about that?
She's allowed to have her opinion. She's still going through an amazing trauma. I'm not going to, contest anything that she has to say. She's allowed to have her feelings and allowed to state them.
What if you don't raise more money? What if that interview, there are a lot of people talking about that interview that he said, what if it doesn't make any more money for you? What if that's turned off people, then what?
Well, but for that money that he is indigent. He has no other money. So, but for that, then I think he would have to be declared indigent by the court and have the eligibility of county and state funding.
What did you ask Barbara Walters for? On The View this morning, she said she flew here for an interview, mm-hmm. and then after the fact, she was told that she would need to do something that
yes.
would violate ABC News' policy. What
yes.
did you all want? Was it money?
George asked her to provide a residence for 30 days, for 4 weeks, for his wife. George, is very concerned that he may be rearrested. I mean, the judge, as you know, in a previous order sort of suggested that. So George is very concerned that he's not going to be around to help. But specifically, the request was provide residence and security for my wife for 1 month. And now in one sense, that is a monetary demand or request, and no agency can do that, no news agency can do that. I think George was thinking, I don't want money in my pocket, but I want my wife to be secure for at least a month if things don't go well. And I think that that's not a horrible request to make, and I think Ms. Walters, who I appreciate her not saying that because she didn't want to disclose, but I think that was the specific demand or request, and they could not assent to it. I think that that has now been rethought by George, and we'll see what happens in the near future.
Is it fair to say Hannity did pay something, whether it be a hotel stay or vacation or something? Did he agree to do something in exchange for that interview?
Absolutely not. Hannity, Fox, paid not a penny for it at all.
Mark,
nothing.
First, George Zimmerman says he regrets nothing from that night. Later, he comes back and he says
yes.
sorry about the death. Yes. Does he regret what happened that night or not?
My understanding of what George was saying when he first responded to it, and you guys can really look at it and come up with your own, he thought that he was responding to, would he have changed anything in dealing with the police? Would he have changed anything with being so cooperative, with taking the test, with doing everything he did? And I believe what he was responding to was, I would not change anything about that. When the question was re-asked, because it was obviously questionable what he was talking about, he told Sean Hannity exactly what I think he always has felt, and I think anyone would feel. Had anything changed, had he not gone to Target, had Trayvon stayed 5 minutes longer at the 7-Eleven, had anything happened to have changed the intersection that happened, we might have had a different outcome. But we do that in every days of our lives, with every car accident or every tragedy that happens to us, you hope things could have been different. You got to deal with what happened, not what may have happened.
Every time he recounts those events in detail, someone could always pick apart a word here or a perception
sure.
there. And last night he says Trayvon was skipping away from him, not running in fear, when previously he said he was running.
Right.
Contemporaneously he said he was running
sure.
on the call. Doesn't that hurt your case and his credibility if that gets to court?
I had always said that you have somebody give 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 statements about any event over a period of time, and if they are completely consistent, then it's a lie. Because only if it's completely consistent can you say the same thing. Other times when you respond and talk about it, is it certain now that Trayvon Martin was skipping? I don't think that's what was exactly meant. I think he was responding to Sean saying, well, was he running, actively running away in fear or not? Again, 6 people, one person first, the judge, and then 6 people will decide the facts of this case of whether or not George Zimmerman acted in self-defense. That's really the issue at hand.
You did step in at one point when the discussion came to what was known at that April 20th bond hearing. to what degree did you intercede, because there's now a phone call where you were talking about a transfer of money and whether you could be in jeopardy because you maybe knew more than you have claimed so far?
No concern at all. That was really about the other charges pending, maybe with George and definitely with Shelley. But let me respond to that question. I had a conversation with George recently when I first listened to the call number 30. I do recall he talked something about a transfer. This is going back a few months. He did not talk about any specific amount of money to me because, quite honestly, you know, those are the things that I would remember. If somebody says to me, I have $37,000, I'm a defense attorney. I'm going to say, goes on the affidavit. And by the way, why am I doing this pro bono if you have $37,000? So it doesn't make a lot of sense that the only alternative theory would be this. I knew about the money. I knew about not just 37, but the whole 150. And I decided to lie and commit suborning perjury. And then every other thing that is antithetical to who I am. And then 4 days later, have a complete change of heart and tell the judge about everything. You know, sorry if there was some inconsistency in that tape that you think maybe I knew more than I did. You're going to have to either believe me or not.
But what happened?
What happened with?
This idea of the transfer, it just clicked over.
He said something about not being able to make a transfer about a website that, in my mind, don't forget, I knew of two websites. $1,500 with LegalBroom.com and $700 or so with Frank Taffy. If that was my filter and he was talking about a transfer that was having a problem, it really wouldn't have reached level of significance to me, because I was still trying to get ready for a bond motion, having met him, 8 days before or 6 days before, and everything else that was going on, you know, including some of this. So that's all I can say,
Mark, so money is tight. If the opportunity comes up for George to make some money off of some potential television appearance, we'll be seeing more of him. You're going to give the okay to go ahead and do that?
I don't think that he can nor will be making direct money off television appearances. I think that if he has an opportunity to further present to the public George Zimmerman, the real GeorgeZimmerman.com, then he wants to do that solely for the purposes that he is broke and he cannot provide security for himself or his family.
So he will be looking for ways to monetize sort of what's happening with him?
He needs